Hello everyone, this is Satish Kumar. I am here with another lesson on Indian economy. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the financial market, a very, very important lesson. Okay. So, what is financial market? See, it is a place or a market where people with surplus fund and people who want fund will meet and do a transaction. Okay, so there are two people. One person is having surplus fund. The other people want fund. So these people meet in this market and they will transact. Okay, the person with the surplus fund will lend to the person with the less fund, the person who wants the fund. Okay, so the basis of the transaction is interest, okay, or dividend. So the financial market can be organized or it can also be unorganized. Okay, and based on the time period, financial markets are divided into two major segments. One is money market, where there will be short term lending. Okay, short term funds are transacted, that is up to 1 year. Okay, that is money market. And in the capital market, there will be long term transactions, medium term and long term. Okay, so above 1 year. So that is called capital market. Okay, so the difference between money market and capital market is the time period. Okay, it is not about the value. Okay, don't think in the money market there is less value and in the capital market there is huge value. Okay, the difference is the money market, it is up to 1 year, the period is short term. So as I said, so first we will see the money market. So as I said earlier, it is a short term lending and borrowing will take place. Okay, and here some instruments are traded, and we will see all these instruments in detail, what are the instruments and what are the features about it. So instruments like commercial paper, treasury bills, certificate of deposit, commercial papers, and all these are sold, trade credit. And these instruments, no, are highly liquid. What do we mean by highly liquid? Anything when we say it is liquid, it means if you say some instruments or asset is liquid, no, it means that could be converted into cash immediately, that could be converted into cash without losing much without losing a lot of value. Okay, suppose if I have a 1,000 rupees bond, if I could easily sell the 1,000 rupees bond for 1,000 rupees, or at least for 990 or 9 like that. Okay, I am not losing much value. Okay, that is called, that instrument is called a liquid. But if I have a bill which is 1,000 rupees, and if I am going to sell it, and when I sell that try to sell that bill and it is not fetching me value and I'm going to lose much of money, no, that is not liquid. Generally the instruments that are dealt in the money market is highly liquid. Okay, that is a very very important point. Okay, and the trading here is done in a rate known as discount rate. Okay, so for example, if a person lends to other person, no, okay, suppose if take an example, a bank wants to raise money. Okay, or take the case of central government. The central government wants to raise money, so it issues a treasury bill. Okay, the central government issues a treasury bill, and this treasury bill is brought by a bank. Okay, bank is the buyer. So bank has surplus cash and it wants to invest in something. and the government wants money, so it is issuing a treasury bill. In this case, they meet at the money market, and here what happens is, when suppose the government is selling 1,000 rupees worth treasury bill, no, and bank when it's purchased, no, what will happen is, when there will be a discount, that is, they will buy in, for example, if it is 10% rate up, in such a case, they will buy it for 900 rupees. Okay, take some 950 like that. Then that 50 rupees, it is the discount. So while the bank will pay only 950 to the government, but get a 1,000 rupees bill, and while repaying the money, the government will pay 1,000 rupees. So that 50 or 100 rupees that is discounted, no, that is the profit. Okay, so there is no interest paid, but rather there is a premium which is based on the face value of the that is the instrument that is sold. Okay, I hope you understand it. We will see that in clear further also. Okay, and the borrowings in this market may not be supported by collaterals. Okay, and this market is both unorganized and organized. It has both organized and unorganized market. Okay, in the Indian money market there are two types, organized and unorganized. In fact, before 90s and all, no, there are too much of unorganized market, but off late we are having a very sound organized market, but still there is also unorganized market that is highly prevalent in India. In fact, overcoming that problem is a major problem for governments. Okay, now we'll see the definition of capital market. What is the capital market? So as I said earlier, no, the capital market serves the purpose of medium term to long term transactions, that is above 1 year. Okay, and here the instruments that are sold, no, are generally in the form of stocks, bonds and debentures. Okay, see, the government when it wants to raise money, no, it may either issue for a period up to 1 year, that is called treasury bill. Okay, if it is going to issue above 1 year for a debt that is above 1 year, that is called dated securities, and it is will be considered like a bond. Okay, and these are all will be issued in the capital market. So the difference between money market and capital market is time period. So please remember this point. There is also the industries offering stock market, then there is corporate issuing debentures, are all come under this area, the capital market. Okay, in fact there is also another market called stock market, which is part of capital market. Okay, capital market includes stock market. Okay, we will see stock market also. Okay, see, another major factor is the money market will be useful for firms to meet their short-term finance requirements like working capital, and the capital market serves the purposes of building capital for industries or businesses. So that capital market will help in the investment in capital formation, and money market helps in meeting the working capital requirement of in the businesses and other. Okay, that is one of the difference. So capital market of two categories, that is primary market, where there is a fresh issue of securities are offered to the public, and there are also secondary market. In the secondary market, the already purchased fresh securities, no, are traded between the investors. Okay, so please remember this point. Take the example of a stock market. Okay, see, if a company wants to raise money for the first time, it will offer in the name of initial public offering. This is a primary market where the company itself sells the equity shares to the initial by initial public offer. So here the people will buy that share, equity share, by in the initial public offer. But later on, when the when that customer wants some money, no, he may sell it to another person. This happens in the secondary market. So this is the difference between the primary market and secondary market. In the primary market, the business firm itself operates because it is the seller. But in the secondary market, the business firm is not involved. It is between two people, the person who want to buy that instrument and the purple person who is having that security to sell it. Okay, I hope you understand what is the difference between primary market and secondary market. So here I have tabulated the different between money market and capital market. So we have seen money market is a short term lending and borrowing transaction takes place, and in the capital market there is medium and long term lending and borrowing take place. Okay, and we have already seen money market will use instruments like treasury bills, certificate of deposit, commercial purpose, etc. Okay, these are all traded. And capital market deals with equity shares, debentures and bond. And in the money market, there will be banks, there will be central bank, RBI, there are also financial institutions and chit fund. All these people are there. In fact, they will sell or they will lend. Okay, they will sell the or they will buy in the money market. They will lend or they will borrow. In fact, we all know that RBI will lend or borrow. Similarly, banks will lend or borrow in this market. Okay, these are all the people involved here. In the capital market, again, capital market also banks will involve, and additionally there are stock brokers, individual investors, stock exchange, etc. Okay, and the money market is highly informal, but capital market is a formalized structure, institution. Okay, and the as I already said, the instruments in the money market are highly liquid, but the instruments in the capital market are less liquid. Okay, that is, if you want to immediately sell a instrument of capital market, no, you will have to lose the some amount of it, value of it. But in the money market, the instruments that you are holding, you may not lose much of the value. In fact, you may not even lose the value because they are highly liquid. That is the definition of liquidity. Okay, and since it is highly liquid, no, money market instruments are, there is a low risk. Okay, but the capital market instruments are high risk instrument. Whenever something is low risk, no, it will also bring low returns. That is the amount that profit that instrument holder, no, he will get only little return because he is investing in something that is low risk. But in the capital market, as the risk is high, the return will also be high. Okay, please remember this point. Then previously, as I said, no, money market helps businesses in meeting the working capital needs. Okay, and the capital market deals with the helps in capital, building capital infrastructure. Okay, like investment in machineries and other things. Okay, capital market, both are very important for an economy, right? Both serve some purpose. See, I have given here the need for money market. Okay, see, there may be businesses who have invested lot of money with a huge investment and high capital machineries, but they need some working capital to run those things. Okay, even a rich businessman with huge machineries, no, and they also need working capital temporary working cap, temporary finance to run their business. And sometimes if these working capital are not available, the business may find it difficult to run, and sometimes they even close with all that machine placed in their industry. Okay, so money market serves a very, very important purpose in providing working capital requirement that will help the business to keep on running, okay, and to meet the short term requirements whenever it happens. Okay, hence it is a very, very important instrument. Okay, if it is not there, there will be lot of industries due to lack of some small fund has to close or close down for a temporary period, and this may lead to lesser production and employment, loss of employment, then the economy will suffer. So money market serves such a very important purpose. Okay, and this money market is a very, very important place in helping the implementation of monetary policy. In fact, RBI relies on this market to control the money supply in the economy. Okay, in fact, whenever RBI does the monetary policy, the instruments, the different instruments it uses, no, the immediate effect will be seen in this money market, because in fact RBI uses this channel. So it is a effective place for implementation of monetary policy. Okay, and the funds that are raised in the money market by the government, no, will not add inflationary pressure on inflationary thing on the economy. That is, it is non-inflationary. See, if the government want to raise the money by issuing currency by from RBI and issuing currencies, no, what it will happen is when new money is printed, it means there will be inflation. Rather than that route, when the government trade in the money market by issuing treasury bills, no, it doesn't involve any that is not it is not a inflationary form of finance for the government. Okay, please remember this point. So that is why the money market are so very important. So now we'll see the money market in detail. Okay, what are the different types of instruments available in the money market? First, we'll see the money market when it got organized in India. See, the unorganized money market will always be there since man doing any form of trade with the money, right? There will also be people who have lent loan to other people since ancient times. Okay, but the practice of organized money market is a very, very recent phenomena, especially just some 30-40 years back. Okay, in fact, the Sukma Chakravarti committee that was appointed in 1985, it actually underlined the need for an organized money market in our country for improvement. Okay, and then the Wagul committee came, and it was for the money market. It was the Wagul committee was actually dealt with money market, and it laid the blueprint for the development of money market. These two committees are very, very important. Please remember, these are dealt with money market. Okay, in fact, Chakravarti committee emphasized the need for a organized money market, and Wagul committee was set up to recommend on money market, and this Wagul committee made some recommendation, and as a result, lot of instruments, organized instruments of money market came. We will see all this today in detail. Okay, but still, despite India having an organized money market, there are still, as I said earlier, there is an unorganized money market. Okay, we all know that there will be a chettiar who will be loaning money to people, right? There are business firm who will loan money to others, right? So there are money market in India. unorganized money market. So these two money market exist side by side. Okay, please remember. First we'll see the what are the different types of instruments that are available in the organized money market. Okay, the most important, the first is treasury bills. Okay, this is a one of the major instrument that is traded in the organized money market. And we are, as I said earlier in the banking class itself, this is issued by the government, central government, whenever it wants to meet its short term financial requirement. Okay, it issues this for a period of up to 364 days. Okay, that is 1 year. Okay, at present there are three type of treasury bills. Okay, 91 day, 180 day and 364 day. Previously there was a 14 day bill was also there, but recently it at present it is not there. So these treasury bills are available at a minimum amount of 25,000 rupees. Okay, and its multiples, what it means and it multiples, that is the first is 25 and 50,000, 75,000, 1 lakh, 1,25,000, like that. Okay, and these are issued by RBI in times of market stabilization scheme, that is whenever there is a volatility in the money market, money supply in the economy, these are all treasury bills are used by RBI, okay, to bring some stability in the economy, market stabilization scheme. Okay, and see, remember this point, these are all negotiable instruments, they are easily and freely transferable. What do we mean by transferable? Okay, see, if you are buying a treasury bill from government, right, for 25,000, you have paid 25,000 and you have bought a treasury bill from the government. Okay, see, the government will only take the treasury bill at the end of the period, that is if you have bought a 180 day bill, the government will take the bill only on treasury bill, pay the money back to you and take it back only after 180 days. But sometime after 90 days you feel that you want the money back. Okay, what you can do, you could go to the secondary market and you could sell it. That is what transferable, you could transfer it to other person, you don't need to hold on your hand. Okay, if you wanted you could sell it in the secondary market. Okay, I hope you understand. And as I said, there is no issue interest paid here, it is the discount at their face value. In fact, I have already given this example, what is the discount on face value. So if I am buying a 25,000 bond with RBI for 182 days, I will be paying only a lesser amount. Okay, that is if I am buying 25,000, I will pay 23,000, but I will get the 25,000 treasury bill, and the government will pay after the period 25,000. That 2,000 is the profit here, and this is called the discount rate. Discount, it is discounted on the face value. Okay, please remember. See, most often the investors in the treasury bills are banks, insurance company and financial institutions. Okay, that doesn't mean that you and I can't buy, we can also buy, but the majority will be banks, insurance companies and financial institutions. Okay, banks usually to the statutory liquidity ratio of the banks are generally kept in the form of treasury bills. They will buy these treasury bills of government and they keep it as statutory liquidity ratio. Okay, in fact we discussed this during the banking class. Okay, the second is certificate of deposit. What do we mean by certificate? In fact, this was introduced after the Wagul committee recommendation, okay, in 1989. and these are issued by banks against deposits that are kept by individuals for a period of 15 days to 1 year and also to 3 year. 15 days to 3 year. I will tell you why it is 3 year. Generally money market we say it is 1 year, but here there are 3 years. I'll tell why. Okay, so generally banks will issue this deposit to the depositor who are depositing money for 15 days to 3 years. And when I say bank issue a certificate of deposit for a deposit for this kind of period, no, you might wonder, there is a similar instrument like this called fixed deposit. In fact, in the fixed deposit also you might invest for saying that I have 6 months fixed deposit, like that, right? What is the difference between the fixed deposit and certificate of deposit? Again, here also this is the difference. That is the difference is this is tradable or transferable, the certificate of deposit. So in the fixed deposit, when you invest in the bank, no, at the end of the fixed deposit period, the bank will pay only to you. Okay, and but in the case of a certificate of deposit, you could sell the certificate of deposit to some other person. Okay, you could trade this, and whoever holds that certificate of deposit, that person will get that money from the bank. Okay, so you could transfer the ownership of the certificate of deposit to somebody, you could sell it. Okay, I hope you understand. And these are issued for a minimum of 1 lakh and its multiples, that is 2 lakh, 3 lakh, 4 lakh, right? See, please note the next point that is very important. The RRBs and cooperative banks and the local area banks cannot issue this certificate of deposit. Okay, please remember this point. RRB, cooperative bank and local area banks cannot issue certificate of deposit. And since 1993, RBI allowed the financial institution to operate in it. Okay, and these institutions actually can issue this certificate of deposit with a maturity period up to 3 years. That is why we saw it is in 3 years. Okay, bank will actually issue for 1 year. The other financial institutions like IFCI, IDBI, IRBI, Exim Bank, these institutions are issuing at up to 3 years. In fact, this is started after 1993. But remember, RRB, cooperative banks and local area banks cannot issue certificate of deposit. Okay, the next is commercial paper. See, it is a money market instrument that is issued as a promissory note. Okay, so it is unsecured money market instrument that is issued in the form of a promissory note. Okay, this could be issued for the period of 7 days to 1 year. Okay, so see, in fact, this is also introduced in 1990 based on the recommendation of Vogel committee. See, the major purpose of introducing this instrument is for corporate, that is business class, no, for the corporate, no, to borrow money. Okay, short term borrowing to meet their short term needs. Okay, for that purpose. So companies, corporate companies, no, these companies with sound standing, no, and a large amount of assets, they could issue this commercial paper. A bank could issue a commercial, a corporate company could issue a commercial paper, and they could raise money, okay, for a period of 7 days to 1 year. So it is mostly initially started with the purpose of helping corporate borrowers to raise money. So see, corporate can raise money from bank, and we have also seen other sources, but there need to be more sources. So that is the reason why commercial paper was introduced. And here, not every business or every corporate can issue commercial paper. There are certain restrictions. What is that restriction? Only a company with which has a net worth value of not less than 4 crore, or that is 4 crore or above. It should have a net worth, the company's net worth should be more than 4 crore. Only that company could issue the commercial paper. Okay. And they have to have this sanctioned by their banks. Okay. Initially, it was set up for only for this corporate borrowers, but later on, primary dealers and all India financial institutions are also permitted to issue the commercial papers. What is primary dealers? See, primary dealers are people who are licensed with the RBI to buy and sell this kind of money market instruments. Okay. So they are licensed and they are authorized by RBI to buy these money market instruments. In fact, primary dealers also lend or buy, issue or buy the commercial papers. Okay. And all India financial institutions are also permitted to do that. Okay. Both these institutions can meet to meet their short term funding requirement. No, they could do this. Here is also there is a discount on face value. See, it is issued on a multiples of 5 lakhs, minimum of 5 lakhs and its multiple. Okay, it is issued on the commission 5 lakhs. They could raise 5 lakhs capital, like, and the multiples 10 lakhs, 15 lakhs, 20 lakhs, right? Okay, but please also remember the company that is intending to issue this commercial paper, no, they have to obtain a credit rating from the credit rating agencies that are approved by the RBI. Okay, so rating agencies like CRISIL, ICR, there are other institutions that are approved by RBI. So these credit rating agencies should have given us credit rating, and the credit rating should be minimum of A2, and below that, if any company goes, that company cannot issue the commercial papers. Okay, a sound credit rating company only can issue this, that is A2 company or above only can issue this commercial paper. Please remember this point. See, also non-resident residents, Indians and foreign institutional investors, they can also issue commercial papers. Okay. No, they can also invest in commercial papers. Okay. See, generally anybody can buy the commercial papers, but in the commercial paper there is also additionally non-resident Indians and the foreign institutional investors, they could also invest in the commercial papers. But however, the foreign institutional investors, know for them there is will be some limit that is set by the Security Exchange Board of India from time to time. Please remember this point. Here it is Security and Exchange Board of India. They may ask tomorrow a question in prelims saying that foreign institutional investors cannot they could ask a question like foreign institutional investors can invest as much as they want in the commercial paper. That is not true, because there is the limit, and this limit is set by SEBI, and they will also issue another statement saying that the foreign institutional investors are set some limit to invest in commercial paper by the RBI. Questions are framed like that. Okay, that answer, that statement is wrong, because it is SEBI. So please remember these kind of points. Okay. Then another instrument is commercial bill. Okay, also known as trade bill or bills of exchanges. Generally, these are done between companies and among companies, or between companies and banks. Okay. Whenever a company wants some money for meet some temporary thing, no, they could issue this commercial bill. Okay, it is a short term instrument, and bank provide this kind of thing for meeting the requirements of company. Okay, again here it is also issued on discount. Okay, then called money market. Okay, see, this is a interbank money market. Okay, generally here a bank and another bank will lend or borrow between themselves. Okay, this is usually done in a period of one day. That is why it is known as overnight borrowing, also called as called money at call. That is why it is called call money market. Okay, it is they will borrow for just one day. Okay, and they are sometimes it is up to 14 days also they will borrow. Generally they will repay it in only one day. They could also borrow for the period of 14 days. When it is said above the one day, no, it is called short notice borrowing. It is not call money, it is short notice borrowing. So the difference between call money and short notice rates, call money is just for overnight borrowing, and above one day up to 14 days, this is called short notice thing. Okay, and borrowing here can take place with security or without security. Okay, and the rate of interest, no, will be based on the repo rate, although it will not be exactly repo rate, it will be somewhere in and around the repo rate. Okay, what do I mean by that? See, this rate will be based on the demand and requirement of the market for this money. Okay, when there is a huge demand, the rate will be higher, the interest rate will be higher. Similarly, when the period is high, the rate will be high. Okay, it is 3 days, 4 days, no, like that, no, the rate will be high. If it is only one day, the rate will be lesser. In fact, the rate in this market will keep on changing from day to day and sometimes from hour to hour, because it is a overnight market, so it could change so quickly. Okay, the rate of interest. Okay, and banks usually lend between themselves. In fact, there will be a bank which has surplus cash, there will be a bank which needs some short term credit to meet that day requirement, so they lend among themselves. So interbank, this is what major purpose. Okay, the scheduled commercial bank and cooperative banks operate in this market. Please remember, when we learned about certificate of deposit, we found that cooperative banks cannot do it, but here in the call money market, along with banks, cooperative banks also could operate in this market. But again, here RRB and local development banks are not allowed. Okay, and LIC, GIC, mutual funds, IDB and NABARD, no, they allowed in this market to function in this market only as lenders. They cannot borrow in this market. Okay, only commercial banks and cooperative banks borrow. The other institutions like LIC, GIC, mutual funds, IDB and NABARD, no, they could only lend in this market, but they cannot borrow. They could lend to other banks, they cannot borrow. Okay, please remember this kind of point, very very important. If you study all these things carefully, tomorrow a question that is related to this comes in the format of any statement, you could easily answer it. Okay, the next is money market mutual funds. Okay, this was introduced in 1992. This was introduced as a way to help the individuals with idle surplus cash to invest in for short term investment. So it is focused on people who are having money to invest in some short term instruments. Okay, money market mutual fund. Okay, and here the mutual fund, no, they will see generally the mutual funds, no, are highly risk, but in the money market mutual fund, that is the mutual fund in the capital market also, please remember this, but the money market mutual fund will invest in the highly high quality instruments. Okay, that is why the money market mutual funds are considered as a safe investment, okay, and low risk investment. Even if there is a risk, it is very low, the percentage. For suppose I say 90%, you may not lose your money value, it is low risk. There is only 10% chance you will lose the money, okay. And because of this reason only, no, this is a preferable route for people to invest in this money market mutual fund. For people who feel that investing in a savings bank account do not yield enough return, that is, the savings bank offer very less interest rate, no? So people who, if they want to earn a little bit extra, they could invest in money market mutual fund, because it is not a high risk, because there is a very very low risk for loss of money. But again, money market mutual fund is always subject to risk, but the money market mutual fund is a low risk, because the money market mutual fund will invest in high quality instruments, that is high liquid instruments, okay. Please remove this point. Then the other instrument is repo and reverse. In fact, we saw this, the repo and reverse rate, in the while we are studying the banking RBI. See, repo and reverse is the money market instruments, okay. In fact, these two instruments are considered as the most dynamic of the money market instrument, okay. In fact, repo was introduced in 1992 and reverse repo was introduced in 1996, okay. And this is the most favored route to raise short term funds, okay. And this repo allows the banks and other financial institutions, no, to borrow from RBI for short term. And in reverse repo, RBI borrows from the banks and financial institution for short term. In fact, I already said in the previous class, it is the banks and financial institution who park the fund that they are having idle with RBI, okay. And there is a rate for it, and that rate will be the interest. Here interest is paid, okay. This is not a discount thing, the interest. See, again, this is also like the although the interest rate is there, it is a discounted rate, because here it's also, it's paid in the face value, sorry, huh? And see, generally the repos are done in an overnight period, okay, like one day. Sometimes it will also go for extra days, but generally it's for overnight repo. But if the period goes behind one day, no, it is called term repo, like 3 days, 7 days, 14 days, 28 days, like those are called term repo. In fact, RBI Urjit Patel committee, no, it recommended the term repo and term reverse repo, because it will bring more stability to banks, because banks may need money which they cannot repay within a day, okay. Sometimes they may need for 1 week or 10 days or 20 days, like, okay. So the period is called term repo, that is 1 week, 7 days, that is called term repo. Overnight repo is just lending or borrowing loan for only 1 day, okay. I hope you understand this point also. Then we have cash management bill, okay. This was introduced in August 2009. This was introduced to meet the temporary cash mismatch of in cash for government. So the government which want some money to meet it is to some short term requirements, no, for them this was issue, cash management bill. The government issues this, the cash management bill is issued by government to raise some short term money. Okay, and it is very similar to treasury bill. Okay, the difference between treasury bill issued by government and the cash management bill is, treasury bill I said no earlier, it is issued for 91 days, 180 days and 364 days, but cash management bill is issued for less than 91 days. Okay, a shorter period. That is one difference. The second difference is, see, the treasury bills are put under what is known as ways and means of advances. Okay, since 1997, and in the ways and means and advances there is a limit set up by RBI. It was mutually determined between RBI and government, and beyond that limit the government cannot raise money. But there is the cash management bill is an additional form of raising temporary money. Okay, that is, it is not included in the ways and means advances. Okay, I hope you understand these 2 points. So I've given you what is ways and means advances. So either RBI gives temporary loan to center and state government to meet the temporary mismatch in cash flow, and it was into, see, the ways and means means advances came into being, that is, it was applied to treasury bills in 1997, because before that government, whenever it felt it want money, it used to issue ad hoc bills, okay, temporary treasury bills. But to stop that practice, no, this ways and means advances are proposed, and there is a limit of amount that government could lend, and this is mutually decided between RBI and government. Okay, that is what I said previously. Okay, and the interest rate of this ways and means advance, that is treasury bill, no, it just is charged at the repo rate. Okay, please remember all these points. Then there is Discount and Finance House of India Limited. Okay, this was set up in 1988. Again, this was set up on the Wagle Committee by RBI, public sector banks and the financial institutions. See, this is to the aim of Discount and Finance House of India Limited is to stimulate more liquidity in the money market. Okay, see, as I previously said, no, the treasury bills, no, those bills are issued by government, and the government will buy only after the period ends. But when people want to trade it or buy it before, no, they need some place, and this place is the Discount and Finance House of Limited, which helps the to do this kind of trades. Okay, and it is a secondary market, and this helps to meet those people's needs. Okay, I hope you understand what is Discount and Finance House of India Limited. So we have seen all the instruments of money market, organized money market. Then there is also unorganized money market, where there are unregulated non-bank financial intermediaries, indigenous bankers and money lenders. Okay, see, these are all people who lend money to the known people, right? The difference is in this kind of money unorganized money market, generally in the unregulated non-bank financial institutions intermediaries, no, there will be chit fund nidhis and loan companies, no, they are highly exploitative in nature. That is, they charge huge interest rate, like 36%, 48%. Okay, in fact there are like that institutions even today. Okay, and there are indigenous bankers, like people who lend to people, right? And they are like a bankers, they also receive deposits. And finally there are money lenders, right? And this is the most localized form of money market. In fact, it is a very traditional money market. And there are professional money lenders, like people who used to lend money. And I have known people who used to lend money, and they every day they will go to that place to raise the interest or get the interest or the part of premium. Then there is also the non-professional money lenders. These may be people like businessmen and industries who lend money, and they will earn some interest, okay, to meet their business requirements. Okay. So with this, I end this lesson. We have seen all the important money market instruments. In my next class, I will discuss about money market reforms, and we'll also look into the capital market. Okay. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and keep watching. There will be more lessons.